It's actually a funny story.
Tell it.
I only got two songs in the repertoire.
Hey, we have all night. There's still a shitload of old styles, so tell.
So check it out. I feel like fuck it, right? So there was this girl back in the day. Her name was Bonnie. And no one really knew who she was friends with. She would just show up in the group of friends every once in a while. And she was like this beautiful alternative chick. She had like a shaved head, but like angel face. You know, she was so pretty. And everybody in the group of friends was like in love with Bonnie. But no one knew who the fuck she was or why she was around. Rite, you might... Did you know Bonnie? Shit, yeah, see?
Nobody knows.
I know, but I thought maybe Bonnie was. Like,
dude, she kind of crossed the line.
That's what I'm saying. Nobody knew.
New York and Willowbrook.
Yeah. Anyway, you would have loved her. Yeah. So the point is it's one time I actually went on a date with Bonnie.
Yeah.
Yeah. Woo! It was one of the highlights of my early dating life, for sure. And we made out a little bit. We went to a movie, we made out a little bit, and I was so excited. I'm like, holy fuck. Like, the first person I called was my friend Dennis back there. Because we all had this, like, affinity for Bonnie. I'm like, dude, you're not going to fucking believe it. I just went on a date with Bonnie. We made out. Holy shit, it was so cool. And he's like, dude, you saw her lip ring, right? She's just got a lip ring. And I was like, yeah, whatever, who cares, right? And he's like, well, dude, we don't know anything about this girl. She could be, like, doing drugs somewhere. She could have got that lip ring in, like, a crack house or something.
We knew one thing. At the time, just prior to that, I heard she was staying before he decided to stay at her funeral hall.
It's the kind of girls I go for. So Dennis, as a good friend, speaking of friends.
I trust her too, but it's kind of like, I don't know.
No man is a failure who has Dennis. So anyway, so Dennis, like, he put this fear in my mind, like, dude, we don't know anything about this girl. Like, you better go get tested. Like, you know how to find her, who knows? And so I kind of like just never really called Bonnie again because Dennis fucked me up like in the head. And so Dennis now, you know, years later, loves telling the story to people and he gets a kick out of ruining my chances with Bonnie. And so so he was telling the story to some friends like a few months ago and I was inspired to go home and write a song about Bonnie. There we go. What you gonna do when the sun comes up, trying to get her out of the fire? Thank you.